Soraya.
Wait. Are you? No. Are you Jeff Brenneman from Brenneman?
Yes.
Will you sign my CD when it comes in the mail?
I think I already shipped it.
Oh, okay. Well, you'll have to let me know when I can have it signed personally. I appreciate that. But yay, congratulations. Today's launch day of Brenneman. Yes. And if you haven't ordered it already, Jeff's 6-song EP is available on Bandcamp.
Yes.
So, hooray.
Yes, and
show us the album.
We just got these a couple days ago, so I'm excited.
With this fabulous artwork by your friend.
Mm-hmm. Yep, my friend Tony Lozano painted that. It's originally on a pizza box. And if you look real closely, you can actually see the little vents for the pizza. So where the hot air comes out on the each of the corner. Because it was an unused pizza box that he painted on.
That's beautiful.
That's what medium he does. So
I love it.
It's out. So
yay!
Marco. So thank you for that.
And some folks that we've had on our podcast also make appearances on your album, your EP. So Chris Kakavas, Matt Devine.
Yes.
Jason Victor.
Yes. Yes. So,
and of course, Jeff Brenneman, who's here all the time. And Jeff, okay, I want to give you that little plug because this is a great day. And because the album has officially launched. But today, we're going to talk about a different side project.
Mm-hmm. Indeed.
Okay. Yes. So do you want to let people know what we're going to talk about today?
Yes. So today, we are talking about the band Battery Acid, who released a couple releases, this Rita full-length album and this single right here. So the Superstar single. So they released this first and then Rita came second. So the reason why we're talking about this band Battery Acid is because Luis Gutierrez from the 3 o'clock after Mary's Danish and his wife Gretchen made this album Battery Acid. So it's something that we've mentioned. We talked to Luis about a little bit, which we'll talk about later, but we wanted to dig into it a little bit further, although we don't know a lot of information, but We're gonna see what we can find out about Battery Acid.
All right, so let's jump into it.
Hi, this is Soraya.
And this is Jeff.
Our podcast is called Paisley Stage Raspberry and Rhyme.
A podcast where the two of us play music that we like and share anecdotes and background about the tunes.
We hope you'll join our conversation. And without further ado, a groovear.
Let's get groovy.
Groovy. Groovy. Groovy. Groovy.
All right, let's get groovy.
Yeah. So one thing we didn't mention, which we should have, is, you know, and I think we were trying to tie it in. Why Luis Gutierrez? Why are we talking about it now? Because, interestingly enough, one of the Record Store Day releases coming up in a week, right? A week from Saturday.
Yes.
Is a beautiful orange vinyl re-release of Salvation Army's debut and only album.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. So and that's being put out by Yep Rock. I've seen only photos of it, and I'm hoping my local ye old record store we'll have a copy waiting for me. If not, I'm gonna have to go through other means, and Beth Drenneman may have to help me. But
I think we'll be able to find copies of that. I'll be in Denver at the time where it's 18 degrees right now, and I'm going to be willing to trudge through the snow and wait in line for an hour at a Denver record store in hopes of getting it. But I think our chances are pretty good of obtaining the copy.
I hope so. And I'm willing to elbow anyone that gets in my way. But
I'm sure you are. I'm glad.
But anyways, so, you know, what's interesting about Battery Acid. So, yeah, we were really fortunate to have a really lovely talk with Luis Gutierrez. And we talked about a lot of the work that he's done. But Jeff, battery acid, I didn't find too much to help me understand a little more about the forming of this band. All I know is, so the album Rita comes out in 96, and it's self-released on a label called Absinthe Records. Do you know more?
I don't know much more about it other than it came on the heels of Mary's Danish. Lewis told us that they never really broke up, that they never really dissolved. It was just record label issues and finances and what have you, and they just decided not to release anything. But Gretchen and Lewis and their bass player Chris Wagner went on to release this because they still wanted to release music, but Mary's Danish was in this indefinite hiatus, which they're probably ended now that with the loss of one of the members, David King, but they were in an indefinite hiatus, and this just came out because they still wanted to make music at the time. But we learned I was just gonna say, so this was kind of the end for Lewis and Gretchen that we were talking about before we started recording, as far as musically speaking.
Yeah, it's just interesting because, I mean, you and I have always talked about how prolific Lewis Gutierrez is as a musician, you know, and he does so many different things and he does them just really well. He's got such a solid foundation. And it's just hard to think that, you know, this is kind of where his path just takes, you know, it just takes a turn. And we're not hearing from him as much, you know, and there are these kind of pauses, you know, because like you said, you know, they were on indefinite hiatus. I like to think they're still on my indefinite hiatus, you know, and for the right project, you know, he'd come back. But this album, so it's 96. So if everyone starts thinking of 96 and the musical trends of that time, this album kind of fits into it, but there's a lot here. And if you think, and from 96, it sounds dated. No, I mean, there are some songs that are very much, they plug into that time, but there are some that are just, you know, they feel very punk. They feel and nice and loud.
Raw.
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, there are some licks in there that I go, oh, that reminds me of a different band and a different song. So there's a lot going on here, and it's a fun listen to me, at least.
Yeah, me too. Or,
and I'm specifically talking about the full length album.
Yes.
Yes, there is, and you know, thank goodness for YouTube that people take these, like that single, someone's gone ahead and put it on YouTube, and so it is available, because hard to find.
Yes. In any format.
Exactly. I mean, this was and that's what tells me this was a small release, limited release, and to find it, you're hard pressed. So thank goodness for fans that have it and are willing to share it. Yeah. And that being said, if anyone listening could help us flesh out the story of Battery Acid a little more, we'd really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Because in our own research, we came up short.
Yeah, absolutely. And if anybody had a chance to see them live, they played live, I'd love to hear about that, how those shows were.
Yeah.
That would be great. So just rounding out the lineup. So we have Gretchen on lead vocals, Lewis on guitar, Wag on bass, who's amazing. I got to see him play with Mary's Danish. He's really fun to watch. And then on drums, we have David Hart, who played with Beck and Medicine. Remember, we had a discussion with Brad Lehner from Medicine, and Annette, and I think Matt Devine also.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So anyway, so there's a connection there with David Hart on drums. And I just wanted to mention one more thing. Like you mentioned, I didn't find a whole lot of information on them, but this album is mostly produced. It says it's produced by David Bianco, who, here's another connection with our podcast, Soraya. He produced a bunch of stuff But one of the bands that he produced was D-Generation, which included the late, great Howie Pyro, who was on our show. So a few connections that we have as a podcast with this release. So, other than that, I don't know much about it other than it's a fun listen, like you said. This one was a grower for me. It took me a little while to get into it, but a couple of the songs I loved right off the bat. But as a whole, it took me a while. But anyway,
I that's a fair assessment. I think we both have we both share that opinion. Yeah,
very good. But want to listen to some music?
Yeah. So Jeff, today in a huge departure, I'm the one with the lead off track.
Yes.
I'm the one who picked the lead off track. So I just had a thought and then it just went whoop. Anyways,
I'm curious why you picked this lead off track.
I'll tell you why. Because the minute it played, it was like sensory overload and it was just power. This song, to me, it's driven by Lewis's guitar, and it just had so much energy, so much power, and it just grabbed me and took me for the ride. So that's why I picked it.
I was going to say, our buddy Jim over at the JFJ Conspiracy will be very happy with the time length of the song.
So this is Crown on My Head, which runs under 2 minutes, Jim. Crown on My Head, Battery Acid.
My hair still on my head, or it felt like it was just blowing.
It's all like back, man, just like that Memorex commercial back exactly. in the day. But the guitar in this is just insanity, and that's where you go, man, I love Lewis Gutierrez on guitar because he's just a madman on it. Gretchen Seeger, her vocals are so interesting, but they play so well with this, you know, because it's got this very sweet tonality, but it's like hard. It drives hard. Great song. And to start off the album, this comes full throttle.
Yes.
And you're in, okay, now where are you going to take me?
Yeah.
I love it.
So did you ever ride that ride Revolution, Knott's Berry Farm?
Where yes.
you do the loop and you go up and you come back and
yeah.
roller coaster. So I remember the first time I was on that roller coaster, because a lot of roller coasters you track up and build up, you know, you're building up momentum and then you drop. that one was like straight off the bat, just like, I feel like this is the revolution of music, the revolution ride. But anyway, yeah, right off the bat.
Whew. All right, Jeff, what's your pick?
So my pick is actually just a few tracks later on the album. I think it's track four. It's called Bliss. Interestingly enough, Soraya, the two picks that I pick were not produced by the producer. My were produced by a guy named Joe Baresi. He, for some reason, he produced these two separate songs that I picked. And he was a producer that worked with the Jesus Lizard, Melvins, L7, and he happened to work on Kerosene Man by Steve Wynn. So another connection to our podcast. So the album is mostly produced by David Bianco, but these two songs, for some reason, had a different producer on it. So anyways, I picked both of the songs that I picked have more of a melodic approach to them, whereas Crown on My Head is just power and energy. My two step back a little bit, and a lot of the album does have power, but these a little bit less. Anyways, these two songs that I picked were the ones that grabbed me right off the bat that weren't growers at all. But anyways, so hopefully you guys like this. This is Bliss.
My heart.
So late into the track, Lewis picks it up and does that very cool lead. But we were mentioning how this came out in 1996. Yeah, yeah. To me, this one, for the most part, definitely has a feel of that era, almost Nirvana-ish, a lot of stuff that came out in that.
The guitars and the drums reminds me, you know, Soundgarden, you know, has that vibe.
Yeah, for sure. It's still a great track to me. I still love this now. What are we, like 20? This came out 20 something years ago, 26 years ago? If my math is right, 4 plus 22? Wait, 90. It's crazy that it's that old, but the song still sticks with me now. And Gretchen's voice, you had already mentioned that, just sounds fantastic on this. But still curious why they had Joe produce this track instead of David Bianco. I'm sure different session is probably what happened. And the song, like many of them, were written by Gretchen and Lewis.
Yeah. All right. You ready for my next pick?
I am ready. Where did you go next?
Oh, I go way down. Way down in the track listing. I'm at track 10. This song's called Drip Away. A little over 2 minutes. Sorry, Jim. 2:20. But another energetic song. So let's go. Drip Away.
That's a headbanger right there.
Woo! And it goes, it goes through tempos. That's what I found so cool about this song is comes out driving, then they slow it down, then they bring it way back up.
Yeah.
And I hear a lot of different influences here. So I hear like a punk, I hear a lot of hard rock, and a few other things mixed in, but Lewis Gutierrez, salute. Yeah. That guitar is ridiculous. And David Hart on those drums. I mean, everybody. Yes. And the bass, Chris Wagner. Oh my
God. Yeah.
Awesome song.
Yeah. Yeah. And it, like you mentioned, when it goes into that drudgy part, just like drops and just.
Yeah. And then they're like, oh no, you think it's over?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Pretty dynamic.
But also, just with all those tempo changes, Gretchen's voice, I found it to be, it's, she just changes and continues. It's still a headbang.
Yeah.
Love it.
So can we talk about the dynamic range of her voice? Because
yes,
you have these slower songs and she just, she can sound sweet. And then on something like Drip Away, it's like, I don't want to be running into her in a back alley. She, I mean, she's got some power, and she's an amazing singer. So
yeah, it's just, she, you said it, she's got this super versatile range, and it surprises you because, again, I said it back in track one, she's got this sweet sounding voice, but it comes and it's like a 1-2 punch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it can go sweet, hard, rough, and then come back. Like, she does it all. And I think this is a different step from Mary's Danish, where we still heard her voice really contribute so well to those songs. This is like a completely different vibe, and it's like nothing.
Yeah.
But so with it's Mary's, not an adjustment.
Yeah. So with Mary's Danish, she had Julie Ritter next to her, and they were kind of, you know, doing their duets, which they sound amazing together, the two, yes, of them. And here it's just Gretchen. So she's out front, you know, by herself, and just, she can definitely hold her own. This proves it. This definitely proves it. All right. So you picked the lead off track, which is supposed to be my spot, Soraya.
Yes, it is. It is.
All right. So let's bookend this. And I'm gonna close this out by playing the very, very last song. And to me, it's an interesting pick for a last song. I could hear Drip Away as being the end of the album and just ending hard, which is what I tried to do with my thing, just something hard like that. But this Sunday Dress is so catchy to me. It's so melodic, and I just absolutely love the melodies on this. And this is one of four songs that Wag contributed to. He co-wrote with Lewis and Gretchen on four of the songs, and this is one of them. And again, as I mentioned earlier, produced by Joe Baresi, produced Steve Wynn, So anyways, Sunday Dress is the very last song on it, and this is how it closes out. And just listen to these melodies. They're incredible.
Travel through.
just kind of trails off. So this one is so catchy to me. And that psychedelic thing that's happening, that little Beatles part in the bridge, super cool. But I just love this track.
Okay, I'm gonna ask you something.
Okay.
Did you hear what I heard at the very, very beginning of the song? It's a slowed down version. So like dun 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 dun.
Sex Pistols?
Yeah. I'm like, I am an anarchist.
Yes, I thought the same thing. I'm glad you mentioned that.
And I'm like, wow. But like definitely slowed down.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm like, mm. But again, it's a super catchy song. And I really, really like Gretchen's vocals on this track.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
What do you think about this as a closing track?
I think it's an interesting choice because like you, you know, I was much more attracted to the really hard, loud songs. Now, again, I have to say my musical, what I'm attracted to musically is definitely influenced by whatever's going on in my life right now. It's getting close to finals. So this is why I listen to a lot of hard rock and punk, because I'm like, I'm ready for it to be over. But going back, I think it's interesting to start at this super high energy and end with this kind of sweet mix. I don't hate it. I don't hate it. I think if back then, 1996, I would have said, no, you can't end it that soft. You have to end it hard. But, you know, they were doing it and they said, this is how it's going to go.
Yep.
Track and 13.
And I think we've shown that they definitely had some dynamics with this record from the picks that you've picked and some of the more subtle or more catchier, more focused on melody rather than energy.
Right.
So they have all of that in here. And I mean, Sunday Dress is almost a power pop song.
Yep. I'd say that.
But I really like this record. I wish it was a little bit more available. I mean, finding CDs are difficult. And other than YouTube, I don't think it's streaming anywhere. I tried to find it streaming and I had a hard time. So
I'll put it this way. I haven't found it yet.
Yeah.
Streaming.
Yeah.
So, and again, that may be the band's choice. Since it was self-released, they may just say, we're going to leave it where it was. I don't know.
Maybe. And we were talking about that earlier, Soraya, that after this, Lewis told us that he was ready to focus on other things rather than music, right? And I think Gretchen was in the same boat, so. But they're still breathing. So, I did want to mention one last thing before we sign off. And that's with Sunday Dress. Lewis produced a band called Dakota, which later became Dakota Motor Company, a band that I really like. And hopefully we can talk with them. We're in discussions with them if they can come on. Lewis produced their first two albums. This Sunday Dress has a feel like their band too. So, wasn't totally unique to Battery Acid, but Dakota Motor Company has that same kind of feel with melody and a little bit driving songs with a female fronted singer that with hooks that just grab you. So hopefully we can discuss Dakota Motor Company next year with the band.
Yeah.
And Lewis.
And, you know, I'm glad you mentioned that because Jeff, believe it or not, we're coming towards the end of 2022.
That's crazy. A couple weeks away.
We're hitting this holiday stride that everyone hits. Wow.
It's crazy.
Has been a really cool year though. And for us with the podcast, it's been a lot of fun.
Indeed.
So, a couple more before we end the year, but then in 2023, we've got lots of fun plans. So
yes, we do. Some interviews that we're hoping to line up here.
Yeah. But thank you, Lewis, Gretchen, David, and Chris, for a cool album. Battery Acid from 96.
Yes, thank you much. And a little single. You can find it for the vinyl lovers like me. So
that's such a cool single too. I love the artwork on the front.
And Crown on the Head, they put on side B. So
side double A.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, side double A. Yep. and a little bonus track, Close the Door. So not on the album. So
all right, Jeff. So I hate to say it, but it's over.
For now.
For now. So this we hint at
what? I was gonna say, this is not goodbye, it's see you later.
See you soon on the other end of the revolution.
Oh yes.
All right, mi gente, agrullar.
Groove on, Paisley people.
She was just a walking down the street singing, do I do, popping her fingers and shuffling her feet singing, do I do. She looked good. She looked fine. Looked good. She looked fine. And I nearly lost my mind before I knew it. She was walking next to me singing, together nearly every single day singing, do I get it, did it, dumb, did it, do. We're so happy in the tower on the stage singing, do I get it, did it, dumb, did it, do. I'm hers,
I'm his,
she's mine,
he's mine.
Well, I'm hers, she's mine.
Wedding bells are gonna chime. Together nearly every single day singing, do I get it, get it, down, get it, do.
We're so happy in the tower, don't stay singing,
do I get it, get it, down, get it, do.
Cause I'm hers,
I'm his,
she's mine,
he's mine.
Well, I'm hers, she's mine.
Wedding